100.9 The Farm. It's 9:12 with the Green Team. Let's welcome into the Henry County Medical Center studios, Jason Charles Miller. How you doing, man?
Hey, good. How are you?
Doing well, brother. Let's talk about your background, because it's a very different background from a lot of country folks out there these days. It's a heavy metal background, is it not?
A little bit, yeah.
Band called Godhead that was on Marilyn Manson's label?
Yeah.
How did that all come about? And then how did you transition into country music?
Well, you know, I grew up in rural Virginia, and I ended up in this band, Godhead. And what happened was Marilyn Manson's manager saw us, and he was like, hey, we're starting a label, and we'd like you to work with them. And I was thrilled and terrified at the same time. and it's funny because I met him. They like flew me out to meet him at Rick Rubin's house, where they have a big studio.
Great producer.
Yeah, and it was used to be owned by Houdini.
Wow, and, that's sweet.
And, it was really creepy and surreal. But I ended up working with him for about 2 years. And
give me a Marilyn Manson story that we can talk about on the radio.
Well, he loved to prank.
Okay.
So when we were on tour, right when we got off stage, we were opening for him. Right when we got off stage, we're all sweaty, just. You know, it was really hot, some outdoor festival, and he comes running into our dressing room with a bunch of boxes of cereal and just starts dumping them all over us. So then it's almost like being tarred and feathered. You know, you just have cereal just sticking to you everywhere.
Nice. So then how did it come about where you thought, you know, maybe country music's where I should go?
Well, I used to write a lot of songs on my own that all ended up sounding country. My first records were John Denver, The Beatles, and Merle Haggard.
Come on.
That's how I learned to play guitar and how I learned to write songs. So that was my thing. It's like, if I want to do something on my own that really represents just me, it's country music.
You may be the only musician ever to admit he liked John Denver.
I know.
You know, they'll admit they like Bob Denver from Gilligan's Island before
they
admit.
Like John Denver. I'll admit it. Right. Country Roads was my first song.
So you're living in Nashville now, or are you still in L.A.?
I go back and forth.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very cool, man. So where do you want to take this? I know the album Natural Born Killer is now out. Mm-hmm. Is it a rockin' sound? Is it more of a traditional country sound? Which way are you heading?
Well, it's got more of that sort of Southern rock vibe to it. You know, Skinner, Allman Brothers were huge influences on me as well. So, it's, you know, luckily you can kind of throw all those influences in now and combine it and come out and people dig it.
Gotcha. Natural Born Killer on iTunes. Where can we pick it up?
Yeah, iTunes and my website, jasoncharlesmiller.com. Okay. You know, all the digital spots.
We'll debut the new song here in just a moment. It's called The Way You Still Want Me. But first, you guys want to do a song live in the studio?
Yeah.
Who you got with you this morning?
My friend Nick Wynn was coming along with me on this radio tour, and
we're gonna
play a song off the album. It's called As Good Love Goes, She's Gone.
All right, this is Jason Charles Miller live in the Henry County Medical Center studios this morning on 100.9 The Farm.
1, 2, 3. As good love goes, she's gone. Like that, I'm all alone. You got that right, it feels so wrong. Be the only one alone. Wish I hadn't said those things that broke my mind. Wouldn't be here crying. One who's left behind. You say every dog has his day in the sunshine. And I'm just waiting here for mine. As good love goes, she's gone. And I don't think she's coming home. That right, it feels so wrong.
you come back. The fairy tales ain't never end like that. As good love goes, she's gone. On angel's wings, this bird has flown. You got that right.
Impressive.
How nice was that?
Nice.
Jason Charles Miller live in the studio on 100.9 The Farm.